Hi there, it's Megan from MeganMins.com, and today I wanted to share with you how you can plan your content using just a simple spreadsheet. While I recommend that you do use some kind of project management system like Asana, ClickUp, or Trello to actually manage the tasks and execution of your content marketing, I do like to use a spreadsheet to get a high-level view of what my content plan is. That way I have one place to look to see exactly what posts are going live when and what social media posts I want to have going live around the same time as well. So I'm actually going to show you the spreadsheet that I use to plan my content, and just so you know ahead of time, I am actually going to show you like the exact spreadsheet, how to use it. You can feel free to recreate this on your own, or if you would like to go ahead and download this same spreadsheet that I'm using, you can do that by clicking the link below this video and you can get the same spreadsheet today and start using it and not spend time recreating this yourself. Okay, so here is the content calendar. Now this just has some demo content in here because I just wanted to show you how you could use this and how I approach using a spreadsheet like this. So I do have one tab is the whole year. So you can just scroll and see that on the left side, I have a little mini calendar for each month of the year. And I like to group my content that way. If you happen to do themes for every month, then this will work really well for you, or it's just a great way to kind of see the year at a high level overview. So I also have a few different columns here I want to explain. So I have events, which is a great column to just make a note of any marketing or promotion events that you have planned. So if you're doing a webinar or launching a new product, this is a great place to indicate what's going on that week, because as a good marketer, you know that you want your content to revolve around any promotions you're doing. So this is a great place to just keep track of any events that are going on. Then I do have a space here for you to use two different mediums. So if you happen to do just blog posts and that's it, you can just hide one set of these. But I found that a lot of marketers tend to have two different mediums of content. So if you have a podcast, you might also be doing a blog to go with that. Maybe you do like the example here, podcasts and YouTube, but you can easily rename these to be whatever you want. So if you don't podcast and you do a blog, you could just say blog title, and you will see that that gets reflected down the entire column for you automatically. I'm gonna go ahead and put that back, but let me just keep going. So we have one section here for one medium of your content. So in this example, it's a podcast. This, we're gonna put the title once you know it. You can put the topic, ideas you have, but ideally the finalized title also goes here once you know it. And then CTA, which stands for call to action. So this is the call to action for that piece of content. Maybe it's applying to work with you or downloading a free worksheet or registering for a webinar. There are a lot of different actions you could have. And so this is where you're just gonna be, again, strategically thinking about the call to action for that piece of content and making a note of it here. Then we have the same thing repeated for just your second medium. And so then in this example, it's your YouTube topic or title and the call to action for that YouTube video or whatever this content is. And then on the right here is where you're going to be able to plan the themes or topics for your social media posts. Now, I like to recommend that you pick one social media platform to focus on, especially for content creation. So for example, I focus on Instagram right now, but you may focus on Facebook or Twitter or another medium. That's okay. What I've gone ahead and done here is given you a spot for every single day of the week. That doesn't mean you need to post every single day of the week, but in case you are someone who posts every day of the week, this gives you plenty of space to plan out when those posts are happening. So let's focus here on this February example. So I like to use some color coding. I'm a color coding nerd. And so I like to use some color coding here to help me see exactly what days things are going live. And you can create whatever color legend you want here. For me, I have yellow as the day in this example, the day the podcast episodes would be going live. So if I have a podcast episode going live, it's yellow. So I know that the podcast episode where I have here example 3 is actually going live on February 5th. So again, you can totally come up with your own color scheme here. I just did yellow for my main piece of content, which is the podcast in this example. Blue here represents the second medium here. Again, in this example, I'm assuming that maybe you don't post on YouTube every single week, but maybe just 1 to 2 times a month. So you could use blue to indicate that this tutorial A is going live on February 14th. Then I also like to use another color to represent the events. So in this example, I am saying that there's going to be a webinar on April 1st. So I have made April 1st green. So pick whatever colors you want, decide what those colors are going to represent. And that gives you just at a glance what piece of content is going live when. And I just love getting to look at February and see, you know, the volume of content going live versus another month. Kind of gives you just an at a glance snapshot for how much content you're creating and releasing on any given basis. Okay, so again, we've entered in the podcast title, and these are just examples. So I've just said very creatively, example 3, 4, 5, typed in the call to action for that. And of course, you can repeat calls to action like you can see here in this example. And then same thing for the YouTube title and call to action. And then over here in the social media section, so let's say that on Monday, I want to post about my morning routine. I know Tuesday, I'm going to promote that new podcast episode since I know that goes live then. I want to do a day in the life on Wednesday, and then Thursday, I'm going to do my evening routine. Friday and Saturday and Sunday and Monday, I'm going to promote that webinar that's coming up, and you can kind of see this workflow. I'm going to promote the new YouTube video, and then you can brainstorm. I want to do a day in the life on this Monday. So really, you can plan as far ahead as you want to, but it kind of gives you just that snapshot. This isn't the place where you're going to write the actual content for social media. At least that's not the way I've intended it. This is really just that higher level topics, themes, ideas, a place for you to just brainstorm and solidify. This is my content plan for the week or the month, and share that with your team so you all have a central point to reference what the plan is. And I want you to think of this as like a living and breathing document. So as you change your mind, so maybe you decide to swap out this call to action to be some affiliate promotion. You can just update that while you're talking about it on a meeting or a call. Maybe you decide you're going to do that day in the life on Wednesday. So I want you to really think about this as a fluid document that you keep up to date. So anytime you're talking to a team member or you're just like planning out in your head, when you decide you want to swap something around, make sure you're coming into your spreadsheet and making that adjustment so that this is always kind of the final word on what content is going live when. So this is really that simple. I like to come in here and just brainstorm topics as I'm loosely planning out my content and then just continue to refine and update as I finalize things. Now, again, I briefly mentioned this, but I want to just show you guys again that the top row here and in my spreadsheet, for example, in this January section, I have set up the entire spreadsheet to depend on the titles of this second row. So if you change any of these, it'll just automatically update in the whole spreadsheet. And I had to do that for myself because as I was creating new columns and changing things, it was so tedious to like manually copy and paste everything. So if you decided you don't need to have your calls to action reflected here, and maybe you wanted the URL to be here instead, you could just go up to the very top of the spreadsheet and say URL, and it'll update everywhere for you. Same thing here. You could just decide to use these sections for something totally different. Maybe you post 2 times on Monday and 0 on Sunday. You could say, you know, MAM, and you'll see it reflected everywhere. So just wanted to highlight that feature if you are using the spreadsheets that I provided. So this is how I like to plan and manage my content calendar. I love using a spreadsheet. I have tried other systems, and I just keep coming back to a spreadsheet because it feels like a really good way for anyone that I work with, contractors or team members, or even just my own self, to know exactly what the final plan is and to keep this updated as a resource for the entire team and for myself as I create content. So that is how I use a spreadsheet. This one is specifically a Google Sheet to manage and plan my content calendar. Feel free to actually grab this exact set of spreadsheets by clicking the link below this video, and you can download those and start using it instantly. Or if you'd like to recreate this on your own, feel free to do that too. Either way, I would love to hear some feedback from you. If you enjoyed this video, if you download the spreadsheets and use them, please leave me a comment below and let me know what you think. And I hope you guys have a great time planning and managing your content using a spreadsheet.